In the past decade, we've seen a huge improvement in both the quality of the injectors available to us in the aftermarket, as well as the knowledge surrounding how these injectors work and how we need to deal with those in our aftermarket ECUs. We're here with Tony Palo from Injector Dynamics to talk about Injector Dynamics' new X series of injectors. So Tony, for a start, ID, Injector Dynamics, you guys have been in the market for a long time now. I feel like you've really forced the level of knowledge in the industry as a whole to come up. So you started out with products like the ID1000, and that's a really well-known injector. It's really popular, it did a great job. So what's driven you to move to the new X series of injectors?
Well, you know, this started out small. The ID1000 was the first product, and it did great. It built a great reputation. And over the years, that's opened up some doors for us to work very closely with Bosch Motorsport. And the ID1000 was a modified smaller injector, and we wanted bigger stuff. And so when we got to start talking to Bosch, it was, you know, maybe we can build something a little bit bigger. And the ID1300 was our first foray into a custom piece. So that was designed for us to our spec. We went back and forth in the development process and did a bunch of testing and decided what we wanted. So that started the X series of injectors, which is not modified smaller injectors. They're motorsports specific pieces. So
I just want to stop there because there's an important distinction here that I think there's a lot of misunderstanding in the greater industry. Obviously, the injector market has exploded. There's a lot of manufacturers, or suppliers, I should really say, out there supplying injectors to our enthusiasts. And the ID, the X series, are a bespoke injector that is only available from Injector Dynamics. This isn't a remanufactured production product, correct?
That's correct. Everything in the X lineup is manufactured for us by Bosch Motorsport to our spec. Can't buy it anywhere else. And they are unique from anything else that they offer.
And my understanding as well is that even while you're working that closely with Bosch Motorsport to design and develop these injectors, some of the internal componentry is actually still being constructed by Injector Dynamics. Is that right?
Yes, we actually manufacture some of the internal components that Bosch then uses to assemble the injector with. And we did that because we kind of had an open book into what Bosch has available in the EB14 series. It's not good enough to make the ID1700. So we needed to improve some things in there, and we figured out a way to do it, and we manufacture those.
Okay, so in terms of coming up with a design or developing an injector that flows, in this case, 1700 plus cc's, depending on your differential pressure, and still allowing good control down at small pulse width, supplying small quantities of fuel so that the engines will still idle. Those are two very different aims there, still being able to supply a huge amount of fuel and maintain idle. How do you go about that, and where are the sort of priorities placed on that injector's design?
Well, it depends on the size. So obviously the 1050X and the 1300X2, they're going to be based around a lower horsepower car. So if somebody wants a bigger injector, we have that available. When we start getting into the ID1700 and the ID2000, it's a race car. It makes a lot of power. We get the flow that we need, and we do the best we can down low, and we're able to fully characterize that. And that's what most of the development process is. We need to make sure this thing opens when you crank your car and it's got 5 bar fuel pressure and 9 volts. And that's not the case with a lot of big injectors. So you run into situations where the injector won't even open.
So just to talk about that there, I think it's something that is overlooked a lot. Obviously, when our engines are running, typically we can expect around 14 volts, the charging system. But as you've just mentioned, quite often, particularly if you've got a weak battery, you might get down to 9 or 10 volts during cranking. And if you're running those very high fuel pressures, which a lot of people are these days, that higher differential pressure across the injector makes it harder for the injector to physically open. Hence, when the battery voltage drops, this is the situation where the engine may struggle to start.
Correct.
Now, moving on with that as well, you've talked about the characterization and the linearization. Can you just talk a little bit more about what exactly that means and how that's going to affect the average tuner?
So the short story is injectors have a linear operating range. When you're in that range and the computer wants a 10% change in fuel, assuming the injector offset is set correct, you actually get that 10%. But that's not the case in the lower range. And the bigger the injector gets, the more into that lower nonlinear range you are, at idle and at light load. And so if you don't have any kind of linearization down there, some ECUs do it, some ECUs don't. So we provide all that characterization information for an OE ECU, Motec M1, any of these ECUs that have it. And that makes everything predictable. It makes everything work exactly like it's supposed to down there.
So if you don't have that linearization or characterization data, then you can expect, first of all, a funny shape to your fuel curve, potentially down in those low flow areas where you're effectively fudging or baking in an error into that fuel table. And then, of course, all of those corrections like you just talked about won't work correctly. In terms of the fuels as well, we're seeing a move now from a lot of people moving away from pump gas. Ethanol blends are becoming more and more popular, as well as some of the nastier race fuels. And this can be a potential compatibility problem with some injectors. How do the X Series handle those fuels?
The X Series were designed with that in mind. Ethanol is huge now. Ethanol is not the best lubricant, and all of our internals are corrosion resistant against ethanol. You know, we're talking about pieces that have lift measured in microns. So they're very, very tight tolerance pieces, and they don't do well with contamination and lack of lubricity. So that was a key with all of our X Series.
So again, as you were saying earlier, a true motorsport injector designed from the ground up. Now, just to talk about one of the products that you've got a very close competitor to, the ID1000 versus the 1050X. So if someone was to upgrade from an existing ID1000 to the 1050X, can we expect any differences that would be noticeable?
The dynamic flow is going to be higher, as well as the static flow. It's about 5% more flow. A lot more pressure capability. The 1050X is good to 10 bar. So the there's a lot more capability. The linearity is slightly better, but in the end, you just get slightly more flow with no loss in performance on either end.
Of course, we're also seeing a drive for engines to make more and more power, and particularly when we're running on fuels such as E85 or methanol, where we physically have to inject a much higher volume of fuel to make or support the same amount of power. We need to see bigger and bigger injectors. So the ID1700, obviously you can increase the fuel pressure. That will effectively flow more fuel. Have you got anything bigger in the pipeline, or is that about as big as you can really go?
So the 1700X was as big as we could get. You know, 1700 wasn't necessarily the goal. Make the biggest we can that performs well, and that's where we ended up. We do have some bigger stuff in the works, though. We expect an ID2000X to come, and potentially something even bigger than that.
Okay, well, exciting times. Definitely your products, as well as the data that you provide to the tuners, makes our lives a lot easier, and hence we get a car that runs better. Now, if our viewers want to find out more about the X Series injectors or any of the Injector Dynamics products, where can they go?
InjectorDynamics.com. Everything you want to know will be there.
Awesome. Thanks for the chat, Tony.
Yep, thanks.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.